Hi, welcome to this video. In this video, I'm going to reverse engineer a UR soldering station. I did it because I wanted to fix a heating sensor problem. But in the meantime, I also made a draft design of my own soldering station. So what will be the contents of this video? First, something about the soldering station that I'm using. Then the problem I had with it. Then the reverse engineered UR design soldering station, the solution to my problem, a do-it-yourself soldering station, still a draft, and something about calibration. So this is the UR 9070 soldering station that I'm currently using, and I'm very happy with this soldering station. So what's the problem? Now, my soldering station showed E5 on the display, and this means that the temperature sensor in the heating element is broken, and I think what they want to show is ES with the S from sensor. So I replaced the heating element with a model called A1321, which was supplied as a spare with the soldering station. But when I turned it on, it didn't reach the right temperature. So I thought there was something wrong with the station itself. So I decided to reverse engineer the soldering station to see if I could fix it. So this is what the printed circuit board looks like. On the top right you have a microcontroller, which controls the whole soldering station. Then you have your LED display in the middle. At the bottom right your potentiometer for the temperature adjustment. In the middle, on the bottom, an op-amp. And on the top left, an optocoupler, which controls a triac, which is mounted at the back of the PCB. So this is what the transformer looks like. It has two outputs, one high current 24 volt output and one low current 10 volt output. And you see on the left the triac, which is mounted at the back of the PCB. And this is what the reverse engineered schematic diagram looks like. So at the right you have the microcontroller, which multiplexes the displays. By the way, the pins from the microcontroller to the displays are not correct because I don't know exactly with which pin they control which segment. On the right you have the temperature input that you can set with your potentiometer. On the top left you have the optocoupler, which controls the triac. And in the middle left you see the sensor input, of which the let's say the voltage is amplified by the LM358. And at the bottom left you see the 5 volt power supply. So some more info about this design. As I mentioned, the transformer has two outputs, a high current 24 volts AC output and a low current 10 volt AC output for the electronics. The microcontroller is from Xilog and it measures the sensor temperature and compresses the temperature setting, which are both analog inputs to the microcontroller. And it also controls the LED display, and it does it by multiplexing the displays. And when the heater is turned on, because when the temperature is too low, the MOC3041 will turn off and turn off the triac, and it does this nicely when the AC signal crosses zero. This is what this triac signal looks like. So you see when it's turned on and off, it does this exactly when the signal crosses zero. So what was the solution to this problem? In fact, you need a different heating element. That was the solution. Because there is a difference in the resistance. The model is also different because it has stainless steel instead of a ceramic, but that's not the most important one thing. The most important thing is the resistance difference. So I compared the two heating elements, and the model that I was using had a sensor resistance of 43 to 58 ohms. But the sensor that I needed to use had a sensor resistance of 10 to 20 ohms. So because of this higher resistance, the soldering station switched off too soon, so they didn't reach the right temperature. So the problem was solved by replacing the heating element with the right model. And this is what it looks like. So the top one is the incorrect one, which is in fact meant for the Hakko soldering station. And the model at the bottom is the right one. But while I was on it, because I thought the soldering station was defect, I thought, let's design my own soldering station. So I based my design also on what the UI design looks like, and some info I found on the internet. And in fact, if you look at it, it can be quite simple. You only need a microcontroller with an AD converter. You need an EEPROM, which is not mandatory, but I use it in my design. Sufficient pins to control a display and some additional components. But for this design, I didn't use an AC voltage, but I used an external DC power supply. And for the multiplexing, I used the same approach as the Yeo design. So not multiplexing the whole display, but multiplexing each segment per display. And that means you need less components, only a few resistors. And while I was on it, I thought, let's add some more features. So I also included some buttons to store preset values. This can be handy if you're switching between soldering with lead or silver. And I need, of course, one button to go back to the variable temperature. I also included error detection, which is present in most soldering stations like this one. So ES meaning that the sensor is either short circuit or open, and EH meaning that the heating element is not working anymore. And I also used the watchdog feature of this microcontroller. And this watchdog prevents a hang-up of the program, which can be very handy, because if your program hangs and your heating element is turned on, it might destroy your soldering station. So this is what my design looks like. So we have this big microcontroller, which multiplexes the displays on the right. On the top left, you have the 5-volt power supply. In the middle left, you see the temperature sensor, which is amplified by the LM358. And the bottom left, I'm not using a triac, but I'm using a MOSFET for turning a heating element on and off. And as I mentioned, I'm using three preset buttons, two preset buttons and one for, let's say, switching back to variable. But then the question, how do you calibrate this? I was not able to measure the temperature. So I decided to see at which temperature the soldering tin melts okay. And on the UR, there was at 300 degrees Celsius. So I also call this 300 degrees Celsius. And the temperature sensor has a more or less linear behavior. So you can calculate from this 300 degrees all the other temperatures. And my idea, because I didn't implement this yet, is to store this reference of 300 degrees in the EEPROM. So that was it. I hope you liked this video, and thanks for watching.